conversations around electric vehicles in the country right now. What changes do you see in the ecosystem, say, back two decades ago and now?
We launched in 2001, a month before. Subsidies disappeared, okay. Taxes for electric vehicles increased, and taxes for regular vehicles decreased. Very difficult. A blessing in hindsight because we went global because of that and sold more overseas than in India. But I think today the government is relooking at it, right? You're seeing a framework or set of initiatives coming about. I think the country really recognizes that energy security and climate change are key issues. And India has an opportunity with renewable energy to power its entire surface transportation in the future with renewable energy. And since renewable energy costs are lower than gasoline today, gasoline equivalent, you can actually have a society that in the future could be green and cost effective.
Are you disappointed that we don't have a solidified framework in place yet?
I think it's taken a little longer than I would have envisioned. The framework will enable investments. This industry is going to be a $200 billion industry. It's going to need billions of dollars. It's going to need everyone to say, I'm going to put that money if I see a framework on this area. So I think that's important.
Will fuel-run vehicles and EVs coexist in the long run?
I think they will for some time.
For some time.
You can't overnight switch off something, right? But as technology gets better, people are going to see electrics making a lot more sense. As more options are available to people, you will see society automatically choose it. If consumers get a benefit, you know, and it improves society, there's no reason why that adoption won't happen. And you're at a point where the crossover is happening.
So bikes, buses, or cars, what makes more sense for the Indian landscape?
So for me, I think personally, it's going to be about shared mobility. Shared mobility is growing globally at 30%, and India also very high, right? And we need to transport a lot of people in our cities, right? And we can't afford to double the number of vehicles we have. One shared vehicle replaces 10 personal vehicles, right? Shared vehicles also, since they drive a lot more, the benefits of electric are much better because the cost per kilometer is cheaper, maintenance is lower, and electrics last much longer. You know, think of your fan in your home, how often you service it, right? It's just simpler. So if you look at that, it makes sense to start on the shared mobility. Shared mobility, which means buses, which would mean taxis, which would mean three-wheelers, and even shared areas in terms of two-wheelers for delivery and other applications, which is on the rise on this area. And over time, move that more to personal mobility.
Electrifying shared mobility is the key to making it EVs more mainstream?
I think for India it is.
For India.
And it also, I think it's going to have the largest impact in society.
How do you see traditional automobile companies being impacted by the government's push to EVs?
I think some companies are very forward thinking and they're saying, hey, this is happening and we should make ourselves obsolete, right? And reinvent ourselves. And I think those companies are going to be very successful.
Okay.
I think there are some companies that are saying, listen, we want to be status quo. We don't think that's going to happen. This change is going to happen. So I just think it's a matter of strategy for the different businesses. And you're going to see some that become very successful out of it and redefine themselves and some which will go through challenges. And you've seen that at every time. Some incumbents have disappeared and new ones have come up, and you're seeing another transition. You're likely to see that.